Hinduism is not only one of the oldest, one of the purest enlightenment-based civilization. People always tell me, why there are so many enlightened people? Hey, not only there will be so many enlightened people, there will be so many gods. There are so many gods. They are all independent and organically united in oneness dimension. Meditate on this. Infinite, multiple, independent existence of the gods and goddesses alive, functioning, radiating in a beautifully, organically interconnected order of oneness dimension. Meditate on this. Extremely beautiful oneness dimension. Extremely organic oneness dimension. Extremely beautiful order of oneness dimension. If you understand these two statements I am trying to make today, universe is eternal expansion, explosion into itself. Multiple gods independently exist and organically connected in the oneness dimension. If you understand this too, your whole brain will open up to the higher space and higher experiences. I tell you, listen carefully. I'm really telling you. If you meditate on these two truths, cognize these two, your Ananda Ganda will be ready to receive the darshan of gods and goddesses. In Hinduism, God is not political invention or used or manipulated for political power. So forget about all the childish ideas of gods, goddesses. Be very clear. There is a space Kailasa, higher dimension, but does not mean it is up. Higher is not up. You always think higher means up. I cannot show the hand this way or that way. Because you are always logically taught higher means up. I have to show the hand this way. If I have to show the real way, I should say higher. The higher zones are inward, not upward. The Kailasa zone space exists and all the gods, the Hindu Agamas describing, Vedas describing, Indra, Vayu, Varuna, Mahaganapati, Paramashiva. All of them exist. You call them, they are there, responding to you.